Hey guys, welcome to the hands-on tutorial part of this module. In this first video, we're going to look at how to create a CompCare application. So if you're ready, let's go. First thing we need to do is navigate to the CompCare webpage, so www.compcarehq.org, and then I'm just going to click sign in. Here we enter the email address that we used to set up our CompCare project space in one of the previous videos, and the password. Then I'm going to just click on sign in. This will bring us to our CompCare dashboard. And I'm just going to click on the Untitled application, which was automatically created when we first created our CompCare project space. Great. So we see some help buttons here, telling us, you know, how to get started. And then here as well, it's showing us our app preview. We're actually going to use BlueStacks for this, so you can just click it away. And then first thing we need to do is rename our untitled application. So we will call this Super Simple Survey. Remember to always save it. And then here, in the description, we will say this is a super simple survey application meant to demonstrate what CompCare can do. Something like that. Don't worry too much about it. Again, let's save and let's add our first form. So it's going to ask us, do we want to do just a simple survey in which we collect data once, or do we want to track an item over time, which is a case list. So this is something we will get into in the more advanced modules. For now, we're just going to choose survey. So it's going to set up our module called surveys and our form called survey. So first things first, we can keep this module as surveys, and we'll just rename this survey by clicking on the little wheel right here. That brings us into the form settings, and I'm just going to rename this super simple survey. And we'll press save. And so here we can add some additional functionality such as an icon or audio, but you know, as this is a super simple survey, we'll leave it as is right now. So this module, what it serves is, in our case, it allows us to group our different forms under, you know, a particular header. But as we'll see in the more advanced modules, it's also used a lot in case management. So all of the forms within one module are of the same case. For now, you don't really have to worry about it too much. So let's click on our super simple survey. And this opens up the form editor. So we can get right into it and start adding questions. So for the first question, why don't we choose this label question? The label question is just going to display a message to the mobile worker. And let's say, welcome to this super simple survey. I would like to ask you some questions, with your permission, of course. So here we see the display text and the question ID. The question ID is what's going to show up on our data export. So here we can just say introduction for now. And then this logic we don't have to worry about for the time being. So next question, let's add a text question. This is one of the most basic question types. It basically just creates a field where you can enter any type of text or numbers. So here we'll just ask for the person's name. And as you can see, the question ID comes up automatically as name, so we just leave it like that. And then we can either choose to either make this required or not. Making it required means that the enumerator or mobile worker needs to fill in something before they can continue. So let's just leave it blank for now, and we'll come back to that later. So next question, why don't we ask the respondent for their date of birth? That means we'll use a date question. So we're just going to type in date of birth. And again, we can see that the question ID is filled out automatically. You might notice that the question ID uses underscores. This is because it needs to adhere to specific naming conventions. So you're not allowed to use special characters or spaces in the question ID. So for the next question, why don't we add a multiple choice question? Multiple choice questions are very useful in analysis because it limits the respondent to certain responses and makes analysis a lot more easy and reduces the need for data cleaning and grouping. So let's choose this multiple choice one, the top one. This will restrict the respondent to one answer given the question. And let's ask the respondent which countries would he like to go to on holiday? So we'll say, from the following list of countries, where would you most like to visit? Now, I'm going to change around the question ID a bit. And this is because the question ID, when thinking about what should the question ID state, is, well, what do we want to display in our eventual dashboard? And so, from the following list of countries, that part of the question is more for the respondent's benefit. But when we're analyzing our results, what we really just want to display is, where would you most like to visit? So that's what I'm going to type. And I'm just pressing the space bar, and it automatically enters the underscores. So where would you most like to visit? And now if I try to add a question mark, it's going to give me an error, because it's not a legal question ID, because the question mark is a special character. So I'm just going to remove the question mark. And again, we'll come back to this required. So I'm going to add my first choice. And as you can see, the path is below the question. And this circle indicates that it is a choice value. So first country, let's go for India. And you can enter any countries that you want here. I'm just going to do the following list. Japan, add choice. Kenya, add choice. Brazil, then France, and the USA. Okay, great. So for the next question, let's ask the respondent, do they own any pets? So I'm going to click on add question, multiple choice. Do you own any pets? And you can see here, when I enter a question mark, the question ID automatically ignores it. Okay, and then we'll have two very simple choice values, one being yes, the other being no. And for a final question, let's add a numeric question. So we'll add an integer. And then we'll ask them, how many pets do you own? Great. And we're going to do something a little special here. Because when we ask the respondent, do you own any pets? And they answer no, we don't really want this question to show up. So in ComCare, we have what is called display logic, this display condition. And this is the logic of whether or not to show a question, whether or not to display a particular question. So I'm just going to click on this edit button here. And then as ComCare is all drag and drop, it's very easy to create the display logic. So in this case, I want the result to be true when all of the expressions are true. And we're only going to have one expression. So from the question, do you own any pets? I'm going to drag it to where it says drag question here. And I'm going to ensure that the little marker has changed from a red X to a green Nike mark. And then I'm going to let go. And you can see it drops in my question ID form / do you own any pets? And I want the condition to be equal to yes. So again, I'm going to drag yes over to this part of the expression, and I'm going to drop. Okay, and then let's save. Perfect. So now it's only going to display if the answer to this is yes. But that also means that, you know, if they say I do have pets, that the answer to this question cannot be zero. So let's do that now. So again, so which question are we doing the validation on? Well, it's the question itself. So the question of how many pets do you own, signified by a full stop, meaning it's referencing the question itself. And then here I'm going to select is greater than zero. So this means that the answer needs to be greater than zero. You know, if they enter zero, that makes no sense. Or -1 or -2, that also doesn't make any sense. It needs to be at least one or more pets. So we can save. So let's run through our questions one more time. I'm going to start with name. And, you know, this is a pretty critical question that I want them to answer. So I'm going to click required. Date of birth, again, there's no way they're not going to know their date of birth. From the following list of countries, where would you most like to visit? I'm also going to make it required. Do you own any pets? I'm also going to make this required. And then how many pets do you own? I'm going to leave this unrequired because, you know, in the case they don't know, we want people to be able to finalize their questionnaire and submit it without having to enter any false data. So very simply, I'm just going to click save. And there you go. We've created our very first super simple survey. In the next video, we're going to look at how to publish the application, export the data, and test it.